It's been 3 months since political turmoil erupted in Malaysia, seeing Mahathir Mohamad step down as Prime Minister after his ruling coalition collapsed. But now he's determined to get his job back.
Of course, he can last the full term, but he's going to be in very great trouble. Whatever chance we have to prove that it is not legitimate for him to be the Prime Minister, we'll do that.
Muhyiddin Yassin was part of Mahathir's government and unexpectedly emerged as the new Prime Minister in March after forging an alliance with Malaysia's long-dominant UMNO political party to gain a parliamentary majority. The opposition accusing him of stealing power by shifting alliances instead of earning it at the ballot box. And Mahathir now vowing to oust the new Prime Minister at every turn.
He apparently had a two-seat majority, and that is the narrowest majority any government in Malaysia ever had. The people have elected a government. It is wrong for this backdoor arrangement to be done by Muhyiddin.
Earlier this week, the government avoided a confidence vote tabled by Mahathir, insisting that Parliament gave priority to the fight against coronavirus and its economic fallout. The opposition is now threatening to block all bills put forward by the Prime Minister.
Between now and the next parliamentary sitting, which is due in July this year, I expect a lot of horse trading in the background. The current Muhyiddin government has a wavering majority between 1 to 5 MPs. So if Mahathir and Anwar Ibrahim can convince some of the MPs to move back to Pakatan Harapan, there's every chance that we'll see another regime change back to Mahathir in the near future.
Having led Malaysia for 22 years until 2003, Mahathir came out of retirement and defected to the opposition, winning an historic election in 2018, which made him the world's oldest elected leader. Kirsty Johansson, ABC News.